All right, guys, so today we're going to be talking about a few classy knives, or knives that I think are pretty classy at every price range. And without any further ado, guys, please don't forget to comment, like, share, subscribe, check out the Patreon, the Instagram, all that fun stuff. It is very much appreciated. Okay, let's jump into it. Okay, so first off, we're going to start off with a budget knife. And this one is going to be the CRKT Pilar. Now, the Pilar has been around for quite a while, and this is actually the extra large or large version. I think it's just large, not extra large. Can't remember, but it's the bigger version of the normal sized Pilar. Now, full disclosure, this one does have the Flytanium custom. Now, full disclosure, this one does have the custom Flytanium carbon fiber scales, so I wouldn't necessarily consider in this current configuration this large Pilar to be exactly budget, because it is, these scales are like $56 themselves, so them alone are actually more expensive than the knife as a whole. So definitely take that into account if you do decide to dress this one up with the Flytanium carbon fiber scales. I personally really like the carbon fiber scales. I think they're really nice and they do make the knife more classy. But by and large, even this as just a steel frame lock, it comes in around $35, and it is using 8CR13 MOV for steel. But the base stock large Pilar is a really nice classy knife and it does look really good. Personally too, this one was also customized to remove the flipper, which is something that I actually like and I would probably have done myself, because I think this knife without the flipper looks really good. Just from a side profile, it looks very clean, very nice. And once again, this thing is running on IKBS ball bearings, so it really does flick out quite nicely and quite fast. And it does have a reasonably large thumb hole, so if you're trying to get your thumb in there to deploy it, you can. If you're trying to spidey flick it, this thing spidey flicks so well with that little opening hole. And so you do have to learn it a little bit. It's not the most intuitive right off the stop or right out the gate, but I do think the reduction of the flipper and just flipping it out with spidey flick or thumb opening is really nice. And if you do, like I said, decide to go with the carbon fiber scales, that does make it a lot more classy. Though once again, that does bring it up to like $80 in total. But in stock steel form, this blade is about $35. So really affordable, really cheap, and in my opinion, a really classy knife that is also super utilitarian. Easy to get a nice four-finger grip, whether you're choked up or not. So that is the CRKT Large Pilar. Okay, next one up on the list and stepping up a little bit is going to be the Spyderco Para 3. Now, the Para 3 is one of my favorites, and you could even insert the Para Military 2 into this list, but I think the Para 3 is a little bit more size appropriate for classy knives. I'm trying to keep it reasonably small, but the Para 3 is awesome. And this one, of course, like I said, is a little bit of a step up, whether you're going with the modded or non-modified Pilar. This one is going to run you about $130 in this configuration with the CPM S30V and just black G10. Of course, you can also make your Para 3 a lot more expensive by going with different steel options and different flavors of handle, different colors of G10. But overall, I think in this black and satin finish, I think it is really classy, and that's why I wanted to throw it on the list. But you could also go for things like micarta, which would also look really good. I think they have like a brown micarta CPM crewwear version of this blade, and that is also a pretty classy option as well. But this, even in its stock configuration, still looks nice. And the cool thing about this guy is it does use that compression lock, so it's easy to open and close one-handed. And of course, you can easily spidey flick this guy out, and it does have a four-way repositionable clip. So really nice knife, and once again, really classy, hard to go wrong with, and it's just a little bit more expensive than the Pilar. Okay, stepping up from there into the next kind of price bracket. So first one was about, you know, under $50. The first one over $100 or right around that $100 mark. Now we're stepping into $250 to $300. And in that one, or in that category, I'm thinking just about any ZT in all honesty. But for this one, or for example, this is a ZT 562. Keep wanting to say 462, but it's a 562. And of course, with this one, it is carbon fiber. So similar to the Pilar, even though those are aftermarket scales, this is stock scales. But I really do think that carbon fiber just makes just about any knife look really classy, especially the weave carbon fiber. Just makes it look really good, really clean, and really nice. And especially for, you know, a medium-sized blade like this, really hard to go wrong with that. Now, like I said, there's a wide variety of ZT knives out there. There's also the 462, I think the 462, the 562, or 4. There's the ZT0462, 452, I think, as well, or maybe the 450 is a little bit smaller. Those are both Sinkevich designs, but just about any of them come in carbon fiber, and they are all nice flippers that look very classy. These are a little bit on the bigger side, so as a comparison, I guess we just keep getting bigger as the expense keeps going up. But you can see that that is it in comparison to the Para 3. I should pull it back a little bit, and I'll pull out the Pilar as well and show you. This is a good bit bigger than the Pilar. So hopefully you guys can see there. It's a little bit bigger than the Pilar, but is still a really nice knife. And as far as classy knives go, or for kind of a dressed up situation, definitely would be hard to go wrong with. Okay. Last one up on the list, and stepping it up into the just high-end knives, is going to be just about any Chris Reeve. Now, I have the CRK Nkosi here. I also have the Sebenza 21 as well, and I think both would be equal fits. But overall, for me, and this is actually the knife that kind of inspired me to do this video, or the Chris Reeves that I own, because every time I pick up a Chris Reeve, whether it's my Nkosi, my Sebenza, I just am instantly reminded of how classy these knives are and just how elegant they are. I think that these knives, if you're truly trying to dress up or, you know, really look formal, look proper, and you still want a knife that really kind of fits the bill, these CRKs are super hard to go wrong with. Now, they are the most expensive on this list. Like I said, they are $500+. You can find some on the knife markets or knife forums used for around $400. Sometimes if they're real beaters, you can find them for like $300. But, you know, whether you're going with a small, this is a large in fairness, but if you're going with a small or a large, they're going to be very classy, very clean, very elegant knives. Now, I would probably choose, if I was going for specifically like classy blades, I would probably choose the drop point variant of this as opposed to the Tanto or the Nsingo grinds, because those look a little bit more tactical, a little bit more aggressive, whereas the original just drop point just looks so much like a knife. This is like the textbook definition. When you look at, you know, something like an Nkosi or a Sebenza, this is like the textbook definition of what a knife should look like as far as like its blade shape goes. It really does look like a knife. So it just looks very classy, very up, very high end, very nice, and very clean. Even in its closed state, it just looks like a very clean knife. And especially when you add the inlays, like the micarta inlays, I think are really where it's at for classiness, because they add just a touch of, you know, kind of breaking up the pattern. And so you're not looking at just pure titanium, you're looking at a little bit of micarta on there as well. So whether it's the Nkosi or whether you do decide to go with a Sebenza, I think either of them with the inlays, just about any of the inlays, whether it's the wood or the micarta inlays, are going to look really nice and really classy. So once again, I have to say the CRKs, the Chris Reeves, are what inspired me to make this video. So they're kind of at the top of the list, and they are higher end, but they do look really good. Anyways, guys, hopefully you enjoyed looking at some higher end kind of, hopefully you enjoyed looking at some classy knives, and, you know, hopefully enjoyed the spectrum. Tried to go under $50, around $100, and then, you know, stepping it on up. So regardless to what your price point is, you can find a nice knife that does look classy, that does look high end, that will fit more formal situations. Anyways, guys, hopefully you enjoyed the video. As always, God bless, and I'm out.